Growing up a young boy in Greece with the given name Spiro, it took seeing just one airplane flying overhead and he was hooked. Against his father's wishes, he spent many hours at the local aerodrome watching Army Air Force biplanes take off and land. Eventually, he worked odd jobs in one of the hangars. His ambition became to attend the Hellenic Air Force Academy. But because of limited money and mountains of red tape, his life took a major and very final detour. He decided to join the Greek Merchant Marine in a quest to reach the United States. He'd been told over and over by his family and friends that America was the answer to his dream of flying. The young man was Colonel Steve Passanos, an American flying hero and legend. The passage to the United States tested his commitment, but upon arrival to his first port in the United States, he jumped ship. He arrived in the United States via Baltimore. Fortunately, he knew what to do. His family had given him $8 and taught him the words in English, train ticket to New York, and he was on his way. Befriended by other Greeks shortly after he arrived, his first job was working in a bakery. This allowed him to earn money for flying lessons at Floyd Bennett Field, and what other spare time he could create, he was consumed with learning to speak English. He soloed in a Piper Cub. After only a few hours of instruction, right from the beginning he was a natural, and he earned his private pilot's license in July of 1941. Following the Nazi invasion of Greece that same year, Steve understood clearly he must be involved in the war of all wars, World War II. But the United States had not yet entered the fight, so when he saw an advertisement seeking young pilots to join the Royal Air Force in England, he immediately responded. He first flew the Mustang 1 in the 268 Eagle Squadron before transitioning to the famed British Spitfire in No. 71 Eagle Squadron. In September 1942, the 244 Americans in the three Eagle Squadrons were transferred to the 4th Fighter Group of the United States Army Air Force. Initially keeping their Spitfires, the 4th quickly transitioned to P-47 Thunderbolts. Steve flew many combat missions in this airplane, nicknamed the Jug, and while flying his personal aircraft, Miss Plainfield. He joined an elite society. Shooting down 5 enemy aircraft, he was now an ace. But more importantly, in May of 1943, Steve became the first person to become a naturalized American citizen on foreign soil when, at the direction of President Harry S. Truman, he took the oath of allegiance at the American Embassy in London. In early 1944, his squadron turned in their P-47s for the P-51 Mustang, one of his favorite airplanes and to this day the favorite of many combat pilots. But on a fateful day, after destroying 4 more enemy aircraft, Steve's engine failed and he was forced to ditch in France. He barely escaped capture, but was fortunately picked up by the French resistance. Unable to return to England quickly, he joined forces with his rescuers and fought with them in ground operations for 6 months, until they could get him back to England. Steve's flying career was forever changed, and he entered personally the most exhilarating, daring, and courageous period in American jet fighter development. He was assigned to Wright-Patterson for test pilot training and later Muroc Dry Lake to test fly the newest and highest performing tactical combat jet aircraft. The Army Air Force had assembled the finest pilots in their service. They were there to expedite development of the XB-80 Shooting Star to defeat the feared ME-262, Germany's and the world's first jet fighter. When orders to expedite the testing were reversed because of victory in Europe by the Allies, Steve had accumulated more than 100 hours in the P-59-era Comet and the XB-80, more than any other test pilot. Testing was an especially dangerous occupation in the early days and feared no pilot, no matter how experienced they were in combat, and he was deeply saddened by the loss of Dick Bong and his best friend, Don Gentile. In 1946, Steve briefly left the Army Air Force to work for Transworld Airways, flying DC-3s and the Constellation. But he missed the excitement of flying high-performance aircraft in defense of his adopted homeland and the security provided by the service, and rejoined the United States Air Force in 1948. In those years following World War II, he served at the Pentagon in Southern Europe and earned his Bachelor of Science degree at the University of Maryland while attending the Air War College. Steve volunteered for duty in Vietnam and commanded the 457th Airlift Squadron, achieving a 98.7% reliability rate on over 14,000 sorties. Steve is a recipient of numerous U.S., British, French, and Republic of Vietnam awards and decorations, including 3 Legions of Merit, 5 U.S. Distinguished Flying Crosses, and the Purple Heart. He is a double ace with 10 enemy aircraft kills and a genuine American hero. He has published a new autobiography titled The Flying Greek. The foreword was written by Walter Cronkite, his old friend and admirer. For his invaluable contributions in the defense of the United States and freedom everywhere, and as one of America's leading combat and test pilots, the San Diego Air and Space Museum takes great pleasure inducting Colonel Spiro Steve Pisanos, United States Air Force retired, into its International Aerospace Hall of Fame.